preservation for of the Quran is for our benefit, which means I wish not even a single word from the Quran or the Hadith is gone. But sadly, it's not the story. As an example, Umar al-Khattab, he said the Quran was more than 1,025,027,000 words, which mean more than 80% of the Quran is gone. So the bigger the Quran, actually, the better for us to laugh. The more we will have comedy, and the more we will see and know more about the filth of Muhammad. The less pages we have in the Quran and in the Hadith, the less we know, and the less will laugh about Muhammad. As an example, as we see here, imagine if this, how important if this Hadith, I mean, if it's not there, we will miss a lot. You know what I mean? So it's for benefit of us as a Christians that none of the Quran will be destroyed and none of the Hadith will be destroyed. However, you need to notice that those who collected the Hadith, they themselves, they agreed that a lot of stories about the Prophet is being deleted, for it is not suitable to be mentioned or to be about the Prophet. So what we have today is about all the filter and all the detergent they use in the laundry, which means this is the clean laundry, supposedly. This is the clean laundry, and look how dirty it is. So after the filtration, we have this. So what about before the filtration? Just to show you how sure I am that Islam is nothing but a dirty laundry. What you can mention to me, something you are proud of. As an example, you know, when the Muslim, they say to us, there is scientific miracles in the Quran. I find this is very nice laundry to expose. This is very nice laundry to expose. Because if they did not make the claim of scientific discovery in the Quran, we would not be laughing today at this laundry. So they fabricate, they lie, and then we get them busted, and then people, they will notice that Islam is not trustworthy. Because if Islam is a good religion, why the followers of Islam, they fabricate science in the Quran? Very simple question. Like now, who is a Muslim here? You want to give me something scientific in the Quran? Just to show you, there's thousands and thousands of articles and posts in the internet. We can destroy anything they say in 2 seconds, showing you that Islam is a fraud. For those who they claim that it's miracles or science, the fact it is the opposite. It's stupidity. You ask yourself, I mean, those are stories. I mean, how are we adults? Are we kids? Are we you know, are we idiots? How in the world can we believe in such a thing? That a lizard was trying to burn Abraham, and all the animals they tried to put the fire down except Mr. Lizard. We believe in a book. Actually, our book is book of books. And I find actually very funny our Muslims when they say that we memorize the Quran, you don't memorize the Bible. My friend, all your Quran is not even the index of our Bible. All your Quran is not the size of the index. You memorize what? All your Quran. It's a very tiny part. If we compare between the size of the Quran, there's a guy, he wrote the Quran, all of it in an egg. All the Quran in an egg. You know? And they say to you, we memorize the Quran. Same time, they memorize a stupid book. They don't know even what they are memorizing. Yeah, the Quran is a very small book. You see, when you read in Arabic, like Arabic text, they make the font big, so they can have more pages, but otherwise, the Quran is so tiny, small, very small book. If we compare between the size of the Quran and the size of the Bible, we find that the Quran is not even like the introduction for the Bible. So we were talking about the laundry, and obviously the laundry of Islam is very helpful for us. And I believe the laundry, the most dirty laundry, can be found in the Hadith and in the Quran, which I'm very grateful to have. How on earth can Allah say such a stupid thing? Yeah, well, you know, you see, there is one of the good things about the Quran, that it speaks in the logic of a fool. You know what I mean? So you should be grateful that the one who made the Quran is an idiot. Otherwise, that will make it harder on you to refute it. And this is why, actually, Yesterday I spoke to someone. He asked special request. He's a Muslim, and he didn't want to talk in public. He's a very nice person. He's very, very, very respectful. I enjoy talking to him. And he said to me, "Listen, I don't want to debate you. I just tell me why Islam is not from God. Why Islam is from Shaitan." I said, "I'm not saying Islam is like the Quran. I cannot say the Quran is made by Satan." He said, "Why?" I said, "Because it's too stupid to be by Satan. I mean, there's no way that Satan is so stupid to the point he made the Quran. I believe that Satan is way smarter than this." Now, I told him that I believe that all lies come from Satan, yes. So Muhammad is sponsored by Satan, yes. But the Quran is so stupid. Like, look at this story here in front of us. Right? I did not mention this story for him, but I mean, I mentioned many stories. I mean, look at this story. He found the sun sitting in murky water, Gog and Magog, you know, the angels, the open school of Harry Potter to teach magic. I mean, so this is Shaitan talking. There's no way Shaitan, he made this book. This is a certified donkey who made the book. There's no way Satan, he can be so stupid like this. You know what I mean? The guy, he started laughing. He said, "I don't believe you are saying, I mean," he says, I hate you, but you make me laugh. He said, "Okay, I appreciate your honesty that you hate me." He said, no, "I don't really, I don't mean I hate you. I mean, I hate the way you hit, man. You hit hard. You know, you are not so nice. I mean, did you even know what you just said to me?" I said, "I'm just saying the truth. There's no way this book is from Satan. It's so stupid. Satan is smarter. But I believe Muhammad is satanic, is evil. So he belonged to the tree of Satan, but this book is not made by Satan. There's no way Satan would say the sun set in murky water. I'm sure that Satan, he knew what the sun said. There's no way Satan, he would say the woman have a sperm coming from her ribs. There's no way Satan would say all the stupid things like Israel tried to kill Abraham." Right? This is not, I mean, this is someone stupid idiot speaking to a bunch of naive people, fabricating stories, adding spice to the stories, to make stories. A person who cannot keep his mouth shut and he's bored. That is not Satan. So he said, "So how come you always say Muhammad is from the devil?" I said, "Yeah, because any evil is from the devil. The devil, he come to us in many forms. He come to me as a Christian priest, have a cross in his chest." He said, "Really?" I said, "Yeah. The devil is powerful, he's smart. He come to you from the door you like. If you are a person who like prostitution, he come to you from prostitution. You like gambling, he come to you from gambling. You like money, he come to you from money. What do you like? You are religious, he come to you from religion." This is why the Lord, the Messiah, said, "Be aware of false teachers who come to you in the clothes of a sheep, but they are wolves." So what those false teachers do, they just change the uniform to fit with the customer, right? And then he said to me, "Well, isn't it the Quran says, like, as you see here in the front of us on the screen, like, if you do righteous, how Quran is from the devil, and it says, do righteous." I said, "Okay, do you know what righteous? Righteous is to go and attack the Christian and the Jews and take their money and their women. Righteous is you go to your son, wife, and you flirt with her. Was Muhammad a righteous man?" He said, "Yes, he was." I said, "Okay, did he go to his own son when the husband was not there and he flirted with the wife?" He said, "Yes, he did." I said, "Well, this is righteous." If Muhammad is the most righteous man between all of you Muslims, and he went to the house of his own son, and he flirted with the wife, and later he slept with her, where is the righteous man?